day now. Remember, we are celebrating our ancestors, not mourning them. Okay? So, you know, you give the ancestors a little bit of zest, you know? So let's try that one more time. We offer thanks and praises.
Ashe.
Excellent. I know the ancestors are pleased with that. The libation statement says this. We offer thanks and praises to those who came before us. For this we offer thanks and praises.
Ashe.
Libation Ashe. We are thankful that they lived their lives such that they exemplified the fact that service is more important than success, that people are more important than possessions, that principle is more important than power. For this, we offer thanks and praises.
Ashe.
Libation Ashe. We give thanks and praises for the fact that they lived their lives to the extent that while it wasn't always pleasant, it wasn't always easy, but they always persisted. And so for that reason, we walk the earth and enjoy all the comforts and conveniences made available to us today. So for this, we offer thanks and praises.
Ashe.
We are thankful that we can explore and discover that our essential being is deep within our nature. For this, we offer thanks and praises.
Ashe.
May our children and their children's children carry forth with dignity the history and the nobility of our culture. For this we offer thanks and praises.
Ashe.
And to the creator of us all, may we dedicate our lives to making this world more beautiful and beneficial than we found it. For this, we offer thanks and praises.
Ashe.
To the ancestors of humanity all over the planet Earth, we offer thanks and praises.
Ashe.
Libation Ashe. It is my sincere hope that the Almighty Creator will always bless you, that the ancestors will always guide you, and that our paths will cross very soon and very often during our earth walk. Peace and blessings be upon us all. Thank you.
Thank you, Abu.
Thank you, Paul.
And we're going to start with the blues. You want to do F or B flat? Okay. Bags group. From the top. Yeah. F.
One, two.
My name's J.C. McCauley.
I'm Naisha McCauley, and you're watching AccessTV.org.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
I'm J. Stan McCauley, and I'm exploring a run for mayor of the city of Hartford in the 2019 election. It's undeniable that Hartford has many challenges. However, I believe that our residents are our strength. The question is, do you believe, like I do, in the potential of Hartford? You see the many assets the city has, but do you wonder, as I do, why we are still struggling to move ahead? Do you wonder why the solutions being offered to us just don't seem to get the job done? Well, creating a vibrant city begins with you. We have incredible people who live in the city, who have great solutions to Hartford's biggest challenges. But you don't always have a platform to have your ideas heard, let alone given an opportunity to co-create solutions that work for you. that work for us, that work for Hartford. Hartford's journey will be bumpy, and we'll continue to face highs and lows that challenge us to work smarter and come together as a community that is willing to capitalize on the power of our collective diversity of thought. The challenges facing Hartford will require each of us to act, whether in small ways or big ones. If you're with us on this journey, give me a call at 860-944-9797 and host a listening event for me. Invite a few of your friends so we can explore the possibilities together for a better Hartford.
Thank you. Thank you. My name is Tyreek Marquez. I am a member of Hartford Communities That Care Youth Leadership. For the past 27 weeks, we have been examining the intersection between education, poverty, violence, and trauma in Hartford. I have learned a great deal based on research we have done, but I would like to tell a personal story. On August 27th, 2008, I attended a parade in the north end of Hartford when bullets began to fly and one person was killed. Six people were injured, including myself. I was 7 years old and I was shot in my head, leaving me with partial paralysis, something I still live with every day. I struggle, but I overcome, and I am no different from any other teenage boy. This is why I do things in my community, such as awareness events with my mom and the Victims Against Violence group. I also do things with HCTC because we want to see change. Thank you for taking the time to hear my story.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello, my name is Joshua Fee. I'm a member of Hartford Communities That Care Youth Leadership Academy and the Vice President of the NAACP Greater Hartford Youth Council. For the past 27 weeks, we have been examining the intersection between education, poverty, violence, and trauma, and coming up with program and policy recommendations to improve in these areas. I serve on the Violence and Trauma Workgroup, and we recommend the following. Support hospital-linked violence prevention program. This hospital and law enforcement partnership needs to be fully supported with resources to assist victims of violent crimes. Reboot the Governor's Commission on Youth and Urban Violence to examine the root causes of violence and develop effective policies for the state of Connecticut and its cities. Increase job opportunities for young people and adults to reduce poverty and improve their standard of living. Thank you for your time, and I hope you can support our recommendations.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, I'm J. Stan McCauley, and I'm exploring a run for mayor of the city of Hartford in the 2019 election. It's undeniable that Hartford has many challenges. However, I believe that our residents are our strength. The question is, do you believe, like I do, in the potential of Hartford? You see the many assets the city has, but do you wonder, as I do, why we are still struggling to move ahead? Do you wonder why the solutions being offered to us just don't seem to get the job done? Well, creating a vibrant city begins with you. We have incredible people who live in the city, who have great solutions to Hartford's biggest challenges. But you don't always have a platform to have your ideas heard, let alone given an opportunity to co-create solutions that work for you, that work for us, that work for Hartford. Hartford's journey will be bumpy, and we'll continue to face highs and lows that challenge us to work smarter and come together as a community that is willing to capitalize on the power of our collective diversity of thought. The challenges facing Hartford will require each of us to act, whether in small ways or big ones. If you're with us on this journey, give me a call at 860-944-9797 and host a listening event for me. Invite a few of your friends so we can explore the possibilities together for a better Hartford.
Moscow and played at the Blue Note last week with Ron Carter.
Fantastic.
Alex Nachimowski.
Yes.
In Canada. Our educator, our mentor, everything. We got Michael Scott on drums. The great Michael Scott. Mr. Abu. Started the African dance with Cheryl Smith before the McLeans arrived here at this venue.
All right.
Mr. Rich Goldstein. Adjunct professor at University of Harvard High School, Jackie McLean Institute. Paul Fuller studied with Charlie Gigliotti at Manchester Community College in 76 and took a 2-year hiatus, and now we're back. Thanks so much.